Beijing. I'm Catherine, and the clip you just saw was the trailer from the exclusive play called The Way Alone, designed and composed by students of this very school here, the National Academy of Chinese Theatre Arts. As they are preparing for the Wuzhen Theatre Festival, which is about to start on Friday, they are just rehearsing in this classroom, and in 1 minute we have the exclusive opportunity to have a sneak peek into their rehearsal. Wuzhen Theatre Festival will last for 10 days and the ancient town will be transformed into a giant theatre stage. But if we speak about Chinese theatre, we cannot ignore, of course, Beijing opera and Chinese opera. This traditional art form is often called the river, and the school here, the National Academy of Chinese Theatre Arts, is often referred to as the spring because it's the source of the talent in Chinese acting, stage designing and directing. And we have entered the classroom already, so follow me as we explore the rehearsal of these amazing pieces and plays. Good morning, Tjosha.
Hi. Guten Tag.
Guten Tag. You can speak German, wow.
Right.
I see you're just doing your makeup.
Yeah, I'm doing my makeup for my performance.
All right, so I will not bother you any longer. Talk to you later.
Okay, cheers.
Cheers.
Don't leave me alone.
I'll see you in a bit. So let's see if we can interrupt them for a bit and ask some questions. This is the star of the play, Qiao Qiao. She's performing the role of Li Qingzhao, an exceptional woman of Chinese history. She lived during the Song Dynasty and she was a role model until today for her life, actually. She was writing poems, she was writing books, and she was married twice. She even divorced her second husband, which is quite revolutionary for the times.
Hello.
Good morning, Qiao Qiao.
Hello.
So I see.
This is a 水秀.
Shou is Chinese actress long sleeve in Chinese opera, and in traditional sleeve, they connect together, but in addition to adjust their performing, they separated apart.
Mm-hmm. So it's a very, very long sleeve, I see. How long is it and what is its meaning in the play?
2米.
It's like 2 kilometers.
2 meters?
2 meters. And you see there's ink on it, so it is just like a brush. And in this play, they will using this and to writing a book.
All right, so actually, this stands for a brush.
Yes.
It means that the role was actually a writer or a poet.
Yes.
Okay.
Using calligraphy, Chinese calligraphy culture in their performing.
I see. Okay, there's lots of symbols in Chinese opera then. I'm wondering, you're the director of the play, so I'll ask you this question. How did you have the idea to choose Li Qingzhao's life to write a new play for Wuzhen Theatre Festival?
And it's from a chess, I believe you told about that.
他问到就是你们是怎么想到这个点子，然后那个这是我们几个同学啊在一块闲聊的时候，然后呢我们当时就想做一个戏。对。It's
from the chat they used to have and they want to have a play together, so that's a start.
Okay, so they were just chatting, just talking with each other, right?
然后我们几个同学做戏的时候就想啊，就是当时说到了中国古代的诗词，然后呢，我们就跟乔乔聊的时候，乔乔就说说，哎，我特别喜欢就是中国古代的李清照的词。嗯嗯。So
they were talking about Chinese poetry, and Qiao Qiao, our female actress, was told she liked Li Qingzhao, an Song Dynasty poet, female poet, very much. So they suddenly believe.
然后呢，就是我们一看乔乔说，哇，乔乔，我们觉得你跟李清照的气质实在是太像了，干脆我们就排李清照得了。对，然后就这么定了。
And they just found Qiao's temperament is particularly similar as Li Qingzhao's. What a surprise!
Yeah, I actually think she really looks alike to the photos we still have of Li Qingzhao, right? And from what I see and how I know her, she's also very confident, tough, independent woman. So I think, yeah, you chose the perfect role for her.
关于李清照，她是一个非常独立自主的女性。然后，对于这一方面，你们是怎么融入剧中的呢？就是我们这个故事啊，简单的我简单的介绍一下，就是讲的是李清照。
在他的前夫赵明诚死以后呢，就是续修他亡夫的名著《金石录》，然后呢，在他和第二任丈夫结婚以后呢，去状告他丈夫的一个故事。
So this story is about Li Qingzhao continue write his late husband's work, the Golden 金石录。And she sued her second husband for his abuse.
Yes, wow, that is very, very brave for these times. Because in particular, we have to consider at this time when a woman divorced sued her husband, she had to face jail time.
就是在那个时候，女性如果去状告自己的丈夫，他们是要进入监狱的。
对的，就是在李清照的那个年代啊，就是。 如果说你是妻子去状告老公的话，无论你对错，都一定要先坐牢两年。
Wow.
At that time, if a wife wants to sue her husband, whether the case is winning or losing, she must go to prison at least 2 years.
Wow. So she, even though she knew that, she still continued to divorce her second husband and continued her work, her writing her book. So she was a true career woman. This is can still be a role model in today. So I'm wondering, what is the importance of Li Qingzhao's story in today's world?
Li Qingzhao's 故事对我们现今有什么的影响？
李清照呢，在他的那个年代呀，可以说是满腹才华，但是呢，她毕竟是一个女人，尤其是在当时的那个社会来讲，她的这种性别呢，在她在社会上受到了严重的制约。对，所以说我们这个戏呢，就想体现的就是在那么。自由所做出的这种抗争。
Li Qingzhao has a talent and breadth of mind, but she's still limited only by her gender at that time. So this play will also to achieve those women like Li Qingzhao who have the brave to fight the struggle of their fate or their generation.
Mm-hmm. So against the current of the times, against prefix gender roles, it's a very universal, very timely theme. So she's already rehearsing right now, performing. I am very curious to learn from you, what is the scene that impressed you most in the entire play?
Oh, about these things, how about let's ask another one?
Mm-hmm, sure. So for this play, we have two directors who are also at the same time performers in the play, because for the Wuzhen Theatre Festival, there's a limited amount, a limited size of theater troupes you can bring.
就关于这部出戏，然后你觉得比较印象深刻的点？这个主要是分为两个部分，然后第一个部分是我们将李清照的诗词贯穿到我们整个戏曲的唱和念中。
And there will be two parts. In the first part, we separated Li Qingzhao's poetry in our play by reading and singing two typical ways of Chinese opera.
Okay, can you give me an example?
Okay. 在唱的方面呢，然后主要是我们改编了一首李清照非常著名的词《声声慢》。
In singing part, we adapt her famous poem, 声声慢.
那么在念的部分呢，如果是正常的，我们念诗用普通话。
So, she's now gonna show us how it sounds when she's in a normal way, right?
Yeah.
Speaking the poem, saying the poem, 声声慢 from Li Qingzhao.
可以，我们可以来展示一下这个唱和念的这个部分。对，可以看两位演员的一个展示。
Let's take a look. So you're gonna hear the poem recited normally and then in the Chinese traditional opera style. So this is the traditional Chinese opera style of reciting the poem. Actually, not just the pronunciation and intonation is different, but also the words they use. They are from different dialects in China. The language that is used in Chinese opera has been built over thousands of years. And even for Chinese today, it's difficult to understand what they are saying. So the poem Li Qingzhao wrote, "Shangshang Man," is extremely sad. She just wrote it after her first husband passed away, and she was drowned by sadness and grief. It uses great symbolism. If you have any questions about, you know, Chinese poetry, Chinese traditional opera, please let us know down in the comment below. We will try to answer your questions. So Li Qingzhao is consumed by sadness. And one line of the poem, the last line of the poem actually says that, you know, is sadness really an appropriate way of describing how I feel right now? It's extremely touching. And so you see, if you have the backstory, if you know what's being performed, it's much easier to understand traditional Chinese opera.
And there's another part, also the climax of the whole play, and the sleeve dancing.
Mm-hmm. So this is another highlight?
Yes.
Part that's most impressive of scene? Okay.
You.
Okay, I'm very curious and excited to see the second part. So during this scene, let's just enjoy this particular scene. I think this is when Li Qingzhao took the decision to pursue divorcing her second husband, who was abusive, who was treating her badly, even though she knew she would face jail time. She still continued to go along this path. So it took a lot of bravery, but I think you can also see the way that she moves, she dances. After she took this decision, she's quite confident. She overcame the doubts and she followed her path. No, until today, Li Qingzhao stands for bravery and stands for having a backbone and standing up for your values. So Li Qingzhao divorced her husband not only because he was treating her badly and abusing her, but also he betrayed the country. And he kept her from pursuing her career, which was to finish her book, the book that she began to write with her first husband. Okay, from the music and her movement, we can really see that she's liberating herself. She will go to jail, but she will leave an abusive relationship. She will be free again. And I think you can really feel that from the music. And for those people who just joined us right now, we are in the National Academy of Chinese Theatre Arts. Today we are exploring Beijing Opera, Chinese Opera, because the Wuzhen Theatre Festival is just 2 days away. And as an official preview of the festival, we're going to take you closer as those students rehearse their performance. So right now we're going to talk to Qiu Shi. He's a real expert in traditional Beijing opera, and we've just seen him before doing his makeup, and now he's finished. So there are so many different colors on your face right now. I see red, I see black, yellow. Mm-hmm. What's the meaning?
Well, I think there are a lot of explanations for my makeup, and one explanation I think is more reasonable is that in the ancient China, there's some rituals, and the wizard have a makeup like three pieces of cinnabar, like here, here, and here. Mm-hmm. So, wow, I think when I knew that, I'm so expressed by that. So I think it's from that.
I see, okay. And as I understand, your whole family has been doing Beijing opera, right? Since when did you start to practice your role and practice Beijing opera?
Well, I started to practicing Beijing opera from 6, and now I'm 27 years old, and I'm a graduate student right now, so I have less time to practicing and more time to do studying the theory.
I see, I see. For me, and I think for many of our viewers who are not very familiar with traditional Chinese opera, Beijing opera, I think it's an art form that is rather complicated to understand. There's a lot of symbolism, you know, just in the makeup, in the color of your face, in your clothes, in your movement. I think that's the main difference, right? Because in Western theater, everything is direct, everything is, you know, more realistic. In traditional Beijing opera, it's more symbolic. So if for someone who's just new to Beijing opera, where to start? How can we understand this amazing historical art form?
Well, do you want to learn something from Beijing opera performance?
Okay, sure.
Let's do it.
All right.
First of all, my trait is to perform some heroes and generals and some people who have the spirit of chivalry. Mm-hmm.
So this is the role you train your whole life, right?
Right.
For
right.
this kind of role. Right. All right.
So most of the time, I do pride, proud of myself in the performance.
Pride, bragging, all right?
Bragging.
Putting the microphone away so I can get like my hands, all right?
For bragging. And like this. One, two, three. Is that simple?
Well, no, it's not simple. Okay,
just
step by
three,
step.
Three moments.
Three, okay?
One.
One.
Two.
Two.
And three.
Three.
Three. Yeah, the three we call it
bian lian.
Also called liang xiang.
So you change your face or
yeah,
what? Okay.
I'm not really change my face and just releasing my energy to the audience.
Okay.
Pop.
Pop.
Right. Yeah. Cool.
Okay.
Awesome.
Okay. I'm just learning.
And
what
yeah.
are other emotions that we
yeah.
can try to understand the Beijing
there
opera?
Emotions. Do you want to know how to cry in the Beijing opera?
Cry. Okay.
Yeah.
Sadness, grief. Right.
Yeah. And so now I'm your father. And
you're my father.
You have a daughter. Doesn't treat me very well. And then could you give me a stick? Thanks.
So you're an old man,
I'm
you're my father?
Yeah.
Okay.
And I come here and I want to cry because you are too bad.
I'm such a bad person. Okay, I feel guilty. I feel
yeah.
guilty now.
I'm your son right now.
Oh my God. Wait,
you
teach me one by one, one by one.
Okay.
I. Okay. I'm trying. I'm the mother, you're my best son. Hi. Hi. How did I do? You're really a bad son. Okay, what about anger?
Anger? Well, in the show of Lionheart, I'm really angry because
okay.
I'm going to revenge. For my old brother.
So, Lion House is the play that he's going to perform at Wuzhen Theatre Festival, okay? He's going to play the role of Wu Song, a hero in traditional historical Chinese novel.
Yep.
Okay, anger?
Anger. One. Watch my hands. One.
Okay.
Two. Three. Four.
Okay, I'm not angry. I think I have to really feel it.
One more again.
One more time.
Slowly. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Seven, eight.
Okay. Annoyance, right?
Yeah. There's nothing to do.
I can really feel like...
Only kill him.
From this gesture, I can feel like, oh my God, I'm already like aggressive, right?
Yeah,
so
that's me.
As I understand, your role is actually a police officer turned gangster
yeah.
who's very mad.
Yeah,
he's planning to go into a bar lion house is the bar in ancient China, to kill. He's gonna kill his the lover of his sister-in-law, right? And Wu Song is also very famous for killing a tiger with his bare hands.
Good skill for martial art.
Yes, and you also learned martial art, right, as a part of your practice.
Yeah, the martial arts is included in the Beijing opera performance. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. I see. So I'm wondering, why did you pick this particular scene for the Wuzhen Theatre Festival?
Well, I think this show is really dramatic, and but most of people who appreciate the Beijing opera performance is like, wow, astonished by the beauty, gestures, and movements in the Beijing opera performance. But this one is equal between the story and the performance. So when I was learning this role, or learning the Beijing opera performance, we have to understand the story first and experience the character. And then we use the Beijing opera performance here to fit in the in this story. And so I feel
maybe for the Western audience that are also coming to Wuzhen Theatre Festival, they don't know the story behind it. So maybe they're more impressed by you performing martial arts, doing gestures, mm-hmm. and this scene is very energetic, right?
Dramatic. Yeah, right. But I have some lyrics before I'm doing the martial arts, so people think, know and can understand what I'm doing. And
in English?
Not in English. We have the special receipt in our performance. And I think the between story and the performance is like alchemy. It says the two pieces of metal, a common metal, and get melted by the high temperature, and finally became a high quality metal.
Okay, you're speaking very philosophical, very abstract. Break it down. I think you mean that the story on one hand, mm-hmm. and the performance of the actors on the other hand, yeah. have to go together,
yeah.
right?
I have to polish it and practicing a lot to make it become another high quality metal.
I see. So you studied as well in the US, right, in New York. Yeah. You spent some time there and you were interested in Western opera, Western mm-hmm. drama and theater. Yeah. Uh-huh. Do you think that there are some similarities or maybe it's completely different, the two art forms?
I think it's something similar because I learned some Western theory. It says, Eugene Barba says, there's a pre-expression in the theater before the actor informs some information to the audience. And he or she just stand on the stage but do nothing, and he actually releasing the energies.
Okay, energy.
Energy to the audience.
In Chinese.
In Beijing opera performance, there's a theory, a really deep theory. I cannot understand it before I know the Western theory. It says, I can see how much money you can earn when you are stand on the stage.
I think you mean the spectators, they know what is your role, like how much respect does your role have inside the play just from you standing there, right?
Right.
So how do they know? By your energy?
Yeah, by my energy. In Beijing opera performance, it's called Jing Qi Shen.
Jing Qi Shen, that's three parts of energy.
Yeah. Jing means the sexual energy, and the qi means the inner breath, and the shen means the spirit and the consciousness.
Okay.
I can see you later.
So, before I will let you continue rehearsing, mm-hmm. can you show me how are people seeing the energy of your role on stage with just one pose?
Well, I've shown you, and you just did it. It's like the liang xiang. like ba ba.
It doesn't inform anything to the audience, but I'm relating the Jing Qi.
Very impressive. Just from your eyes, from your posture, we know that you're a powerful man, you're a respectable man, and you are on a mission to kill. Wow, impressive.
Well,
thank you so much, Jiushi. Thank you. Well, we're going to catch up later, okay? I'll let you rehearse. So for those people who just joined us and don't know at all what we're doing, we're here at the National Academy of Chinese Theater Arts, and we have the exclusive opportunity to follow the students of this school as they are rehearsing for the Wuzhen Theatre Festival. The festival is going to start on Friday, and it's going to last for a whole 10 days. And this ancient town of Wuzhen near Shanghai will be transformed into a giant stage with theater troupes from around the world joining, but of course the best actors from China are also going to be there. And if we talk about theater in China, we have to mention Beijing Opera. We have just had the opportunity to see Shandong Opera, which is a local style of opera here in China, and also Beijing Opera. So these different styles of opera are going to be shown at Wuzhen Theatre Festival. But this school here has a lot of exchanges with universities abroad, such as the Zurich University of the Arts. And the same troupe that we are just interviewed, they actually collaborated with Zurich University of the Arts, and they created, co-created together an experimental play called Symbiosis. It's going to mix Western and Chinese elements in a unique and special way that we've never seen before. But as we are entering the building, going to another room, the signal will be very, very bad. So we will show you the trailer of Symbiosis. So you'll be able to enjoy the trailer as we're taking the elevator. And I'll talk to you in a minute.
Thank you.
Welcome back. My name is Catherine, and we are here at the National Academy of Chinese Theatre Arts. They are just practicing musical instruments. So at this school, they're not only learning how to play music, but also how to perform, how to do martial arts, art history. So all of these skills, actors of traditional Beijing Chinese opera have to learn. And the trailer you just saw was the trailer for Symbiosis, a unique experimental play co-created by students of this school and the Zurich School, Zurich University of the Arts. And we are about to enter the rehearsal classroom, and I hope we'll be able to interrupt them and ask some questions, so follow me. Okay, the director is giving some instructions, and we can see very well that this looks completely different than what we have just seen before. We see some Chinese elements, we see some modern elements. I'm really curious to understand. Hi. You're the stage designer here, correct?
Yes, yes, I am. Hello, hello, everyone.
I'm very curious, so what's happening here?
Yeah, we are rehearsing our latest version of Symbiosis. So you can see everyone is in the huge bags. Actually, it's an installation, and it plays multiple roles on stage. Inside every actor helps protagonist to finish the whole performance, and with their body language and the symbolic shapes.
Mm-hmm, I see. So they're moving inside this giant plastic bag, and another role, I think, is looking for its identity, or that's at least my interpretation. Very interesting. So how did the idea for this play come about? How was this play created?
In 2018, we did a project named the site-specific performance with students from Zurich University of Art. During the communication with our Swiss pals, we found that each of us had a lot of great ideas, but it's hard to show them all. It will be perfect plan if there's a solution to make them coexist. Then, hey, Symbiosis is an attractive topic, so we combine all the elements into our first version.
I see. So the symbiosis of different ideas, different cultures, to make something new, to co-create. I think it must have been interesting to work together with those Swiss students in Zurich. You can speak English, but I'm sure maybe not all of your colleagues, classmates can speak English, and the mother tongue in Zurich is German as well. So were there some problems, maybe some cultural differences or some communication issues?
This is an interesting question. Actually, we can see the whiteboard over there.
All right.
Yes, the most interesting part of our group is a new way of the brainstorming. You can see it on the whiteboard.
Mm-hmm.
In the given time, we have 5 or 10 words to come up, and maybe they can be philosophical problems or visual effects. So we divided everyone's ideas into topics and the tools. Mm. Finally, the topics we are most confused or concerned about were selected out and adapted into installations or a piece of performance.
I see. So at the beginning of this play, there was this whole brainstorming process. And maybe that's a way you solve the communication issue a little bit. There are some drawings, right?
Yes.
And it's a clear structure. So what kind of ideas do you have? What kind of topics? And what tools you can use? But were the, did this solve everything, or were there some problems that remain? I'm really curious to see, because I feel that sometimes, you know, the intercultural cooperation can be difficult.
Yes, at first we are argument, because we have a lot of problems, and we think different, we speak different language, and there is a lot of problems in the first. Mm. But when we at the ancient town, we see the ancient building over there. And
in the old town of Zurich?
Yeah, no, in old town in China.
Oh, in China, okay.
Yes, very old town, maybe 400 years later. And then old building over there.
All right.
There is a really good ideas come up to our mind.
So you were inspired by ancient buildings in China?
Yes.
Okay. And then from this point on, you were agreeing that this is the idea, this is the way you want to go forward, right? So
yeah.
This gave you like an inspiration.
Yes.
Okay. I see. So the play is called Symbiosis. And I understand it's combination, but a combination of what? And why Symbiosis?
In this version, we'd like to discuss the topic of breaking formulas and looking for freedom.
All right.
Yes. So in Chinese opera, we have really traditional formulas. We want to talk about if people break the rules, is there a real freedom waiting?
Mm-hmm. I see.
Yes. If you get the, even you can get rid of it, but you are still part of it. So as long as there is a rule, right? Mm. So we think the real freedom is never exist. We think formulas and freedom are always symbiotic. Yes.
Okay, I think I understand. So it's a symbiosis of rules, guidelines on the one hand and freedom on the other hand.
Yes.
And you think those two always coexist, they're always together.
Yes, always together, and the formulas and the freedom becoming man, becoming a person.
Okay, interesting. So I see this is like a symbol maybe for breaking free, breaking through, coming back together again. Okay.
They're always struggling and want to break out something, but it never work out or never successful, because they are always they are unique. Mm. They are one.
I see. I think what also reminds me is that, as I learned just now during this whole live stream, in Chinese opera and Beijing opera, every motion, every part of the story has a meaning, has a symbol, has a rule. For example, to show grief is one movement.
Yes.
So sadness is one movement. But in Western theater, it's more maybe freer how you can express the actions and emotions.
Yes, right. You can see the modern dance, mm-hmm. right? They have a lot of, they don't have rules actually. Mm. They just walk, they jump or something. They can do everything they want to do.
Yeah.
But in Chinese opera, they have a lot of rules.
Okay.
Yes.
Wow, I think this play is really going to resonate with the audience in Wuzhen during the theater festival.
Yes, yes.
Because it combines so many different elements and different cultures. So I hope that you will be very successful. I'm sure you'll be very successful in Wuzhen.
Thank you.
And let's get all together. So CGTN is going to be in Wuzhen as well. We're going to broadcast live for you, but also write articles. And so keep you posted on what's happening in Wuzhen during the theater festival. So please stay tuned. And let's get the CGTN reporters as well on the picture. Come on. Come on, don't be shy. All right. So I wish you all the best. Good luck in Wuzhen. Rocket, are you ready for Wuzhen?
Yeah!
Woo! So I hope you will be successful, and I will see you back in Wuzhen.
See you in Wuzhen!
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.